Some of you may remember a video I did back in February called Bacon for Batchelors. Some people found it funny for some reason. It wasn't meant to be, but anyway. Today is November the 22nd, so I'm about to use the very last of that bacon that I froze in February to make my dinner tonight. And it may seem like an odd dinner, but actually it's breakfast because I only ever eat one meal a day, which is what explains my devastating handsomeness. So, here is the last of it. Throw it into a frying pan, turn on the heat. Don't want it too high. Turn on the fan. Throw this out. And yes, I do have more already frozen. I already brought them in 2 pounds. Anyway, let's move the camera so you can get a look at this and surprise. Obviously, I'm going to speed this up. Smell the grease of it all. Paper towels. Now, while I'm waiting for that, I'm going to chop up some onion for some home-fried potatoes. Having some serious bad luck, but anyway, I'm ready to proceed, I think. Alright, I have my knife, I have my onion. Now, the onion is half. Normally, I would only use half an onion, but I have a little more potato than I normally use, and some of this onion was messed up because it got frozen, so I cut that out. So what I'm going to do is use the whole thing. So I cut it in half, and then I cut it to make half rings, slices. About an eighth of an inch. Of course, again, it comes from. Back to the bacon. Ready for our first turn. Separate. Turn. Separate. Turn. leaving a little bit. I'm going to throw in the onion. Now, some people would disdain this, but I love it. It's garlic. Pre-minced. Keeps like that forever. I've had this in nearly a year. Now, I'm going to do something that normally people don't do. I'm going to put in just a little bit of garlic, just a little bit, into the pan. And the object is for that to burn. And that will give it a very unique flavor that I love. A lot of people wouldn't, but I love it. And now we want the onions to start to brown. And while that's going on, I'm going to chop up a potato. I have a new potato. I recommend either a new potato or a plain white potato. The russets are too starchy. The red blisses and the Yukon golds and the others are too sugary. But the new potatoes and the white potatoes are just about right. Now with a new potato, you can actually leave the skin on it. A white potato I would peel. I'm going to wash this up and leave the skin on, I think. Dry with a paper towel. I don't like to chop a wet potato. Also, eyes need to be removed. The eyes are high in an alkaloid. So if the eyes in your potato, you don't want to eat those. Alkaloids are poisonous, if you didn't know that.